Greetings, Jill. Chief Meteorologist Catherine Thompson here. We've had a pretty active afternoon, and we're not done with the severe storms just yet. We've had a few severe storms pop up this afternoon, and they are continuing. Let's take a look at the radar right now. You can see some downpours, especially still across parts of Summers, Monroe, and Greenbrier counties. A severe thunderstorm warning continues for the northern portions of Summers, Monroe counties, and especially Greenbrier County. This whole cluster is continuing to push northeast into Greenbrier County at around 30 miles an hour. So if you're in Lewisburg, Rennick, White Sulphur Springs, it's not a good time to be on the Greenbrier River Trail. If you're along 219, it's really coming down out there, and this storm could have 60 mile per hour winds as well as half dollar sized hail. We've got to keep an eye on that. So again, take shelter. Make sure you're in a sturdy building. Get away from the windows until this storm passes. It's moving pretty slowly, so it's going to take it a while to get out of here. In addition to that, we do have a flash flood warning out for portions of Wythe County. We had some very heavy rain fall earlier, and it looks like we're going to get another round of heavy rain here in the next few minutes. So if you're anywhere around Speedwell, Sugar Grove, Troutdale, Comer's Rock, Flat Ridge, just to name a few, you could definitely see some flooding. We've also got a flood advisory out for Tazewell County, portions of Tazewell County anyway. Tazewell and Grattan, West Fork, Cove Creek, the Bluestone River, Burke's Garden Creek, just to name a few. If you're around those areas, you could see at least some minor flooding, as we have seen some very heavy rainfall out of storms earlier today. And that's the kind of thing we get often in the summer. You get this just moisture in the air, this moisture-laden air, and then it all comes down at one time. This was actually what it looked like earlier in Bandy, Virginia. It was pouring out there, and we actually had some hail reported in the storm as well. Chelsea May actually sent this video in. I'll give it a second, and it'll actually restart, and you can see some of this coming down. The visibility is just terrible. So if you're out on the roads, it's really hard to see with the rain coming down that hard. Again, please be careful. Now, otherwise, we've been partly cloudy. It's still been kind of hit or miss with the activity. Now we've got partly cloudy skies on our Southwest Virginia Community College camera. Their temperatures right now, a mixture of 70s and 80s, depending on if you've had some rain-cooled air or not. Bluefield just now dropped to 68 degrees. You might have caught that if you were looking at the screen right there at Bluefield. Again, we still could see a few more stronger storms before the night is over, but after sunset, it looks like the chance of rain starts to go down a bit, so I don't think we'll have as much activity. Certainly not as much severe activity to worry about overnight. The chance of rain will spike, though, again tomorrow, at least for one last day. We've still got this stalled front that's been bugging us nearly all week just to our east, but it finally looks to start breaking down and shifting more east, and high pressure starts to come in for the weekend, and that's going to help to dry us out. So let's take a close look at Futurecast. Again, overnight tonight, once we get past 9, 10 o'clock, things start to calm down. In the meantime, more downpours, some severe storms definitely possible in the next few hours. Tomorrow, we'll get some showers and thunderstorms again, especially during the afternoon. I don't think they'll be quite as strong as today. Most of that activity will be further to our east, but we'll have to watch, especially for any localized flooding issues with these heavy rainfall amounts and some of these storms on occasion. So to recap, temperatures overnight tonight, most of us in the upper 50s and low 60s, some showers and thunderstorms, foggy at times, and tomorrow we'll see the chance of rain go back up. We start to get warmer and drier into the weekend, Saturday and Sunday actually looking pretty good, and then we'll start to get more unsettled into early next week and kind of steamy to start next week as well. Hey, stay with us. We'll be right back.